What's up, San Diego? John Brooks here. It's a rainy Sunday afternoon in San Diego, and I had some thoughts here about life. All right, so like, here are the facts. Do you see them? And if you choose not to see them, you need to ask yourself why. Skyline community right now. Just attended a meeting of some community leaders. We did a very interesting exercise on what is your job and what is your dream job. And what are one thing that you didn't do in life that you wish you could have done in life. Basically, it just got us to start thinking about life, what your purpose is. And what it all comes down to, which was my philosophy all along, which I'm glad to know, is it's not really not about you. It's about what can you do for others. What it really comes down to, because making money is what I'm trying to say. It's not a money thing. It's about making others happy, and through that you make yourself happy. So by improving the community, you improve your own life. And someone actually mentioned, because I'm on these streets, so I'm going to skip around a little bit, but Skyline, the streets here are all, they're messed up. It's like potholes everywhere. But I don't see this in my community, right? Every time there's a pothole, boom, they're on it. They're like fixing it right away. And so I don't know if it's the squeaky wheel gets the oil, or just the poor community doesn't get any oil, you know? People don't really care about people who don't have political clout to affect politicians. So kind of sad the way things are, and they don't have to be this way. So I was asked who I am and what I'm all about. So I said, hello, my name is John Brooks. I'm running for the United States Congress, House of Representatives, District 53. So that's what I'm running for. So my background is in public service. I was a wildlife biologist, federal government, then I transferred into law enforcement as a wildlife inspector, and then a criminal investigator, computer forensic specialist, and augmented U.S. Air Marshal for 7 months during the World Trade Center bombing issue. And I'm currently a jazz musician, filmmaker. I run two small businesses and a nonprofit for tiger conservation known as the Nepal Tiger Project, which is a presence absence study in the Himalaya Mountains of Nepal. And so some people would say that I don't know what I want to do. That's so many things. Why are you doing so many things? My argument is life is too short just to do one thing. And by doing many things, I open up myself to the possibility of all things. By doing many things, I understand friend and foe alike. Right? By just doing a couple of things or standing in your own narrow view of life, you really can't see all that's out there for you. And the example I gave was film, right? So in the old days, the advent of television, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, all up to 2000s, we were looking on TV screens that were a 4x3 aspect ratio. And now we're looking at 16x9, right? And so you saw the same thing in this 4x3, but your field of view was narrowed, right? The same information was in there, but once you widen that screen to 16x9, you can see so much more. It was all there, right? So it's always been there. Some people choose to see it, others choose to ignore it. So like with race relations as an example, right? People say, well, Black Lives Matter movement. Well, why do Black Lives Matter? All lives matter, right? Well, that's easy for you to say if you're looking at life from this narrow point of view of privilege in this case. But if you open yourself up to see what other people are seeing, perhaps you can understand them. And just in life in general, I don't know your life because I don't walk in your shoes, but I'm asking you to explain it to me. I want to be able to see through your eyes, right, as a representative. And I don't think there has to be winners and losers I think we all, in fact, this is the game we've been playing to this point. You know, you win, I lose. Republicans win, Democrats lose, vice versa. He's like, no, it doesn't have to be that way. We all have our own vision, our own view of life until our eyes are open to possibilities so we can see things sort of more on an even plane. And until that happens, we will always fight one another to get what we want, and that is the problem. Fighting means someone loses, and this is not good. We do, especially in society today, there doesn't have to be a winner or a loser. There has to be harmony, right? We all can win. So get out of the 4x3 aspect ratio and get into the 16x9 aspect ratio and open your eyes to see things. And so the people who choose not to see, they're doing so because they have this innate fear of loss. Something you lose, and usually people have money or property or something that they don't want to lose. They covet this thing so much, they're afraid of losing it. If you change the rules, I might lose it, and that makes me afraid of you and everyone else. And so the people who can't see sometimes end up listening to the people who choose not to see and pull them onto their side because they're too lazy or not able to research all the information available to show that no, that's not going to be the case. You're not going to lose anything. And so I use this as an analogy towards the global warming issue, right? Some people choose not to see that we are destroying the planet, and others can't see. And so they listen to those who choose not to see, and their logic sounds reasonable, so they say, yeah, that's right, no, we couldn't have done it, and this is just a hoax and blah, blah, blah. You need to educate yourself. And the fact that you're not educating yourself, you're doing a disservice to yourself and to everyone else, right? Now, the consequences of me being wrong on global warming are only going to make the planet and the life, your life better. The consequences of me being wrong and choosing what the naysayers want you to do is going to be devastating for everyone. So there is a loss. If you go my way, you don't lose anything. If you go their way, well, all bets are off. So by addressing the global warming issue, we fix everything. Because we will start on an even playing field, and everyone will be brought to the table because everyone will be included in the conversation, right? Representation was my other point, and I said that we're not, someone who's elected to the House of Representatives should be representing the community, not dictating to the community. Representation, what does the community want? It's not about me, it's about us, right? Not me, us. And until we learn that lesson, things aren't going to change. So I want to represent the community. I want to be the voice for the community, but I will be asking the community what's important to the community, not what's important to John Brooks, other than fixing the global warming crisis, right? Because that affects everybody. Rich, poor, black, white, old, young, doesn't matter. So that's something that everyone needs to be in tune with. All right, so many of you know that I'm a filmmaker, and I want to make this analogy, and I'm going to relate it to the global warming issue. Actually, it's related to many issues, but let's just pick global warming here. So back in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s, when we watched television, we looked at a TV that had a 4x3 aspect ratio, like this. And that can be said that people look through life from a narrow point of view, their point of view, right? And so in the 2000s, we switched to a 16x9 aspect ratio. The same information was available to us, but from a wider perspective so we could see more. The same information was there at the 4x3, but either we chose not to see it or we couldn't see it. But when you widen your field of vision, you're able to see more and understand more. So these people who are global warming deniers, it's because they're looking at a 4x3 television set. Or, well, they are looking at a 4x3 television set, and they choose not to see the information that's available to them, or they cannot see it. So my job, my goal is to widen their field of view so they can see what I see. I'm not trying to change their opinion, I'm trying to provide them with the information. right? It's not a right or wrong issue. It's just like, here are the facts. Do you see them? And if you choose not to see them, you need to ask yourself why. It's a fear of something. It's usually a fear of loss. So the people who choose not to see fear loss. The people who can't see just needs to have their vision expanded so the information can be provided to them. But if they're still looking at the 4x3 screen and the person who doesn't want to see feeds them information on why what they see is not there, they're going to believe that. But if they allow themselves to open up to this field of view, just open yourself up to the possibilities. And then you make a decision, right? An informed decision based on fact. And that can be said not just for the global warming crisis, but for life in general, many things. Racism, equity, housing. You know, people have this narrow field of view that all people that are homeless are poor drug addicts, dropouts in society. And that's not the case either. And since you don't walk through their shoes, you don't know what led them to that particular situation, right? Maybe they were homeless because maybe they had a job, but they couldn't afford a house because the job didn't pay enough. They became homeless and everything else went downhill from them. And then they became this drug addict that you see, the stereotypical drug addict, because they checked out. Life wasn't worth living anymore. You don't know. And as a society, I think we tend to try to put Band-Aids on situations rather than looking at the root causes of why we have low education rates in the society, or literacy rates, what I'm talking about, or people are homeless or don't have a job or doing this or doing that, and they're not like you. Why is it the fact you're saying, well, I grew up the same way, and they don't have the same opportunities I have? Well, blacks, you know, slavery's gone, so you have the same situations. Opportunities I have now. It's not like it used to be. No. You're looking from your TV screen. You're not looking through my TV screen. So, yeah. So I better go because I don't want to get a car accident. Peace out.